Hi guys, Robbo46 here. Welcome yourselves to Tourist Trophy. So Tourist Trophy was a game that came out on the PS2. It's a game that I absolutely loved. I managed to borrow an original PS3 that was backwards compatible with PS2 games. So we're going to play Tourist Trophy, and that is now going to be up on the channel. So we're going to start off with this. I had a few issues with recording the other day, with some really horrible red lines going across the screen, but I fixed that now, and yeah, can't wait to get into this and bring back the nostalgia of Tourist Trophy. So there may be people who watch my videos and maybe never even heard of this game. Maybe you weren't even born when this game came out, but it stands up as one of my favourite bike games ever, made by the same people that make the Gran Turismo series. So yeah, really looking forward to getting back to this. And yeah, you can, as you just seen, set the height of your rider. So yeah, there's a lot of things you'll see in this game that you'll see where Ride got a lot of their inspiration from. So yeah, just get all this underway. So yeah, this intro is going to bring back memories as well. I used to love watching this intro. Just such a good game. Yeah, I will have to fiddle the controls to see what we can and can't use. But yeah, looking forward to this. Yeah, just absolutely loved playing this game when I was younger on the PS2. And the music will kick in a minute. And then it will actually switch to the actual graphics of the game. So here comes the music. Hopefully we won't get a copyright claim for that. Sure, we'll be okay. Okay, and into the actual gameplay. And not being funny, the graphics don't look too bad at all. Even compared to today's standards, it's not too bad at all. Yeah, this game, I played the hell out of this game. And yeah, really, I've wanted to put it on the channel for such a long time. But I know that recording from a PS2 is a real pain in the ass. So, like I said, I managed to borrow an original PS3, because the first lot of PS3s that came out were backwards compatible, so that's what I'm using. And yeah, can't wait to just dive right in. Now, we can't go straight into, well, we could technically if we wanted to go into a race, but we're gonna go into Tourist Trophy mode to start our kind of career. And the first thing we're gonna have to do is get a license, because you can't actually race until you've got a license. So we will be doing that. There's four licenses to get all together, but we'll just go with the first one to begin with, which is more like mopeds. And yes, that is a Rossi helmet and levers. You need to get gold on all of the license events to unlock all of Rossi's gear. But yeah, this game was just such ahead of its time. Oh, I really can't wait to start playing again. Tourist Trophy, the real riding simulator, is finally on the channel. Unbelievable. So, I've just had a little fiddle with the controls. And, yeah, I've got to go with basically default because it doesn't recognise the PS3 trigger as an actual trigger. It just thinks it's the thinks R2 is the R2 button of the PS2. But the face buttons on the PlayStation controller are like pressure sensitive, so I've got to use the X button for a throttle. So basically for this to we basically got to stop the bike, well, the moped, in the allotted space and do it within the time limit. So 27.6 seconds is for gold. But yeah, you got to try and get it bang on if you want to get gold. It's very difficult to get gold. Stop. Stop. Well, we got silver. We're gonna have to try again to try and get gold. I'm not gonna lie, this has taken me quite a few attempts now, but hopefully this one will be the one. So as you can see, my best one is a 27.678, and we need a 649. So we're very close. Come on. Let's try and get gold. Come on. Yes, we've done it. We got gold. There we go, that's the way to do it. Finally. Right, so that is that done. Obviously, you get more advanced stuff, events that you have to do the more you go on. But yeah, so still getting used to the controls, because they're basically using the default controls. So X is accelerate, square is a front brake, gear up is R1. Gear down is R2. Rear brake is L2. So yeah, it's a bit all over the place. I tried to get it like the MotoGP controls, but like I said, the game didn't recognize R2 as a trigger, which is a little bit annoying. Stop. Tell you what, that wasn't far off. We nearly got gold first time there. Okay, let's try again. So let's see if we can get gold with the Honda. So of course do have to change gear with this one, but that's fine. Can we get gold? We literally need to beat our personal best time by a tenth of a second. We're stopping short a distance. Oh, that was close, and we've done it. There we go, another gold. Well, glad that one's done. So on to the next one. What's the next one? Some of the events you got to do, like cornering. This one is a circle one, so we're literally just going to be doing circles. We got to do, I think, yeah, 3 laps in 40.6 seconds. So let's go. And obviously, you can't just go full throttle, because you will just end up going too wide. And it's very difficult to feather the throttle on a face button, on the X button. And there is like a little glitch that keeps happening at the top left-hand corner of the screen, but that's just because of the PS3 emulators. Just having some weird issues with that. Yeah, it is a bit of a pain not being able to use a trigger for accelerator, but it is what it is. Just do the best I can. So we got silver, but we were quite far off that. Try again. Okay. Had a few more attempts, so the best we've got it down to is a 40.7, so we still need to bring that down by just over half a tenth of a second. So obviously staying tighter is a little bit better, because you get round a bit quicker. Okay, it's very close at the moment, neck and neck with my ghost. Oh, he's going wide. We're a bit tighter. That will be enough. That will be enough for gold. But now he's coming through, but he's going to go wide again. I say he. It's me again. Right, just beans. Yes. There we go. There's the gold. That's good. All right, on to the next one. Okay, so we've got to get round this corner, hairpin corner. We've already done a 14.791. We need to do a 14.768. Oh, is this going to be it? Yes, it is. We've done it. Well, that one's done. That took quite a few goes to do as well. Okay. On to the next one. Whatever the next one may be. So, cornering basics 2. Okay. Right, here we go. So, Laguna Seca. Oh. Okay, right. Wasn't ready. Let's go. I was pressing the wrong button for the gears. Right, let's see what we can do. So, got to do it in 32.478 seconds. Oh, spinning up the rear there. Spinning up the rear. That's the trouble with not having a trigger. But, oh no, we're going off. Okay, that's a fail. That's a fail. Try again. Obviously, back in the day of the PS2, didn't know any different for accelerating and that. So, just use the face buttons and used to get on with it. So this game does have the full Nürburgring track on it as well. It has Suzuka. Obviously Motegi, Laguna Seca. But yeah, so happy to be able to go back and play this now. Okay. Oh, that was way off. That was a bronze. Oh, we don't want a bronze. This is just taking forever to try and get gold. I think we might just do this one and call it a day because I'm still quite far off. We're still about 0.7 of a second off and I just can't see myself getting that at the moment. It's the first time it's not actually shown my ghost either. Spinning up too much there. Spinning up way too much. So, well, we got it down to 32.9, but I don't think I'm going to get any quicker yet, so we'll have to come back to this at a late date. Okay, on to the next one. On to the next one. So, corner and basics 3. Okay. Oh, change gear. Usually helps if you change gear. Oh, they've shifted down too quickly. Come on. I used to have a hell of a lot of fun with this game. Literally, even when I fully completed it and unlocked everything in it, still used to just come back to it and play it. Okay, we were quite far off, but we missed a few gears and stuff, so let's see what we can do this time. So, got it down to 24.5. I think we can do this. Hasn't taken too many attempts. So, the rider isn't leaning off very much at the moment. But don't worry, because I haven't actually gone into the riding style editor. Which we'll do after we've done all this. There we go. There's the gold. There's the gold. That one was fairly easy. So how many we got left? 2? Yeah. So this is the penultimate one. High speed cornering on a Suzuki GSXR 600. Oh, okay. I meant to go on the throttle straight away. Didn't realise it was going to be that quick. Okay. So. Bit of a bank in here. Almost like an oval. Oh, no. No, we lost the front there. So, here we go again. Try our luck this time. We've yet to set a time. Now, I'll show you guys like the riding gear and stuff, which a lot of it you have to unlock. You just start off with very basic stuff. But, like I said, if you get gold in all of the license events on all of the different licenses you have to do, then you do unlock all of Rossi's gear as well. And that's a silver. But that's not far off, 3/10. So here we go again. Okay. Yeah, like graphics wise, they're really not too bad. I mean, even by today's standards, they don't stand up too badly at all. Of course, they didn't have like the shine or anything on like today's games and that. But yeah, not too bad. Obviously, it's not in HD. Well, the game isn't in an HD. But yeah, not too bad at all. Physics wise, pretty good. We've done it. We got the gold. Okay, we've got one more thing to do to get our novice license. And then we can go on to start racing. So go on to the final one. Okay. Right. See what we can do. Here we go. So yeah, on this one, you don't necessarily buy bikes per se. You have to do like challenges to unlock a bike. Be that beat, you know, usually it's just beat someone. But obviously when we get to that, I will show you guys. But yeah, Tourist Trophy, way ahead of its time back in the day. It's such a shame that they never actually got round to making a second one. But who knows, maybe one day in the future they will go back and make another one, because it is an awesome game, and you know, would be nice even if they just remade the first one. It'd be really good. But I guess kind of Ride is kind of taking over its mantle. But yeah, oh, that was just bronze. That was crap. Right, we've got loads of time to make up. So 48.7 we've got it on. See if we can beat that. See, you can kind of see like where Ride has got its inspiration from. You'll see even more so when we go to like the Riding Style editor. Although I think in this game it's called Rider Form, so your riding form. But yeah, we'll have a look at that in a minute, and obviously I'll show you guys the riding gear. Oh, nearly had a crash there, just locked up a little bit. So even back in the day, I never actually used to play this with manual transmission, which I am now, but obviously the scooters don't have manual transmission. Well, they didn't have any transmission. Okay, we got silver. I think we'll just leave it at that. Still got a lot of time to try and make up, but I think that we'll just call that a day for the license for now. And the silvers that we've got, we can go back at a later date and try and get the gold. So, we will get our novice license. We have passed all of them. Congratulations. There is our novice license. We are a qualified rider. Thank you. So yeah, just two of them that we got silver in. But like I said, we can go back and get them at a later date. New riding gear has been acquired. So yeah, once you unlock something, you don't have to buy it. So all of this stuff, we don't actually have to buy. It's unlocked. And yeah, we'll have a look at it in a minute. Oh, we've unlocked even more riding gear stuff. So you unlock stuff for getting bronze on every event, gold on silver on every event, and then the rusty stuff on the gold events. Okay. So yeah, Expert, Junior, and Super is left to go. Right, so the next thing we will have to do is challenges, and that's basically where you unlock bikes. So let's go to riding form. See what I mean? Where Ride gets its inspiration from. So obviously it'll be a lot better when I'm on like a proper bike and not on a scooter. But yeah, this is where you do the riding style for your custom rider. So yeah, Ride did get a hell of a lot of inspiration from Tourist Trophy. Yeah, so we'll just sort this out for now. And yeah, if you have played Ride 1 and 2, for some reason they took it away for 3 and 4. But yeah, if you have played the first two Ride games, this will look very, very familiar. But I think you can do more extreme things on this game than you can in the ride games. But yeah, you can get them to really, really hang off the bike. Should we go for a full Ben Spies? Get those elbows out. Seat position. Okay, we'll just go back. All the way back. Lateral slide. So this is how much they lean off, so that's good. Vertical slide. Okay, we'll keep that as is. Leg angle. So you can go for having your leg fully in to having your leg completely broken like that. But that just looks weird, so we'll bring it in a bit. Make it look a bit more realistic. And then your body lean when you're upright. Obviously, you want that hunkered down. So yeah, there are presets as well. You can see at the bottom, neutral, lean in, lean out. And then you've got Form B, Form C, and Motard as well. So you can customize all of them. Or you can do different riding styles and just switch between them on the fly if you want. But yeah, that's the one we're going to be using for now. Like I said, when we get on a sports bike, it will look a hell of a lot better. Yeah, when you get a proper race bike, you can obviously change the number on it. Right, let's have a look at the riding gear so that you guys can see, you know, what that's like compared to the ride series. So got Racing A, Racing B, Street A and Street B. So these are the ones with the red lines across are the ones we've just unlocked. So the plain helmets you start off with and then you get these ones which you unlock. So we'll go with that one. Gloves as well. So yeah, we'll probably go for those red gloves. I think we'll stick with the levers we've got. We haven't unlocked any more boots yet. So that's that. But yeah, that has been a look at Tourist Trophy. There will be more stuff on this. I will be doing a full series on Tourist Trophy. And like I said, I've been trying to work and get this to record and work properly for quite a while. And it's been in the pipeline for a while as well. Just had to kind of, you know, get it all set up properly and borrow a PS3 that was backwards compatible as well. So yeah, looking forward to getting stuck into the racing, which we will do next time. We'll have to do some challenge mode as well to unlock some more bikes. But yeah, that is it from me, guys. I hope you guys are looking forward to watching this series on Tourist Trophy. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to leave this video a like if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel for more content. I shall see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to stay safe and to wash your hands. See you.